Women world over are considered a marginalized grouping, but they are slowly coming out of this bracket of self-pity. The Non-Governmental Organization Coordinating Council, NGOCC, is working round the clock to ensure women in the country are part and parcel of decision-making in every little way as small beginnings yield desired bigger goals. Organization's Executive Director, Engwa Semwale, explains the role of the civil society organization.
We exist to champion gender equity and equality in general, but specifically we work towards the empowerment of women in realizing our vision, which is seeing women not just participating, but also fully benefiting from political, social, cultural, and economic development. So guided by that vision, we pursue gender equality and equity at different levels through the network organization who are actually affiliated with NGOCC.
It is against the backdrop of minimal participation by the women that NGOCC has thrown its weight in support of the Citizens Manifesto that was recently launched by the Civil Society for Poverty Reduction as a build-up to the 2016 general election.
Okay, first and foremost, by nature of our structure, we are a network organization that is currently representing 104 organizations throughout Zambia. And mainly the organizations are those that are focusing on the advancement of women. And by and large, it's women, as we all know, constitute more than 50% of Zambia's population, meaning that, in short, women constitute the majority of the citizens. And therefore, we do fit in the larger citizens, under CSPR, by the fact that our constituency, which is women, are found at almost all the levels of development. And by nature of our championing gender equity and equality, we look at various aspects that are impacting on the women folk. And currently we are implementing a strategic plan that is looking at four main areas as to how they impact on women and children. And the first one being policy and legal reforms. You all know that the legal framework, by and large in Zambia, as it were, does not provide a good kind of basis for women to actualize their rights, especially talking about women's rights. So it is in our interest during this strategy that we are pursuing the policies and the legal framework that is responsive to the unique needs of women and men, but of course with a priority on empowering women. The second area is that where we are also working around influencing our national programs. And our national programs include things such as the national budget process, which CSPR and the citizens' mandate, of course, looks at. We are also looking at the participation of women in politics and also looking at how we can influence our policies and our programs to be in line with what Zambia has already signed at regional and international level. The third area is reproductive health and preventive mechanisms around HIV and AIDS in terms of looking at how it impacts on women. And the fourth area is where we work to promote a media landscape that promotes the voices of women. So by and large, our four strategic objectives fit in very well with the citizens' agenda under CSPR, because NGOCC is also one of the network members of CSPR. And whatever CSPR is championing at the poverty level in terms of at high national level is exactly what NGOCC is also championing. So there is a link in terms of the programs that we're doing.
But what exactly do the women want pronounced in the political party manifestos?
On the gender participation, I think we need to move forward. I know probably we were talking about certain percentages, even at SADC level, where we're talking about the 30%. But we should move again. I think we have moved from that 30% to 50%. But even when we talk about the 50% or 50-50 representation, it's not something that should just be given in terms of numbers. No. People must be able to access this 50% representation based on merit, on their qualification. I'm very sure that no woman would like to get a job because they are simply women, but they believe they deserve and they qualify for that particular job. That is how a country is going to develop. So what do we need to do? We need to put in policies that empower women, our girl child, so that they are able to compete. Stop early marriages, encourage them to go to school so that at a given time, at an appropriate time, you can say, yes, we have a 50-50 representation. That is not only equal in numbers, but even equal in terms of quality for the benefit of the country.
Yeah. On that issue, I think, like the PF, at least they've tried, because I've seen at least there's representation. Most, like you find most of the permanent secretaries are women. When you go in the police, it is the commissioners of police, find 3/4 are women. At least if they could continue, at least to have a 50-50, it would be better. Because I've seen that women work better than men in most of the cases. That's why you find even in most of this corruption, what most of the people are involved are men. It's very rare where you find a woman is involved.
It's very important that we have a balanced kind of equation. We have a lot of women that have gone to school today, and a lot of women, ambitious, you know, that want to go into these politics. But one thing that I would love to see, the women themselves, let them not feel as if they are second to a man. Let more women come up. When more women come up, then we shall have a balanced equation. You know, and I know there are a lot of Zambians out there that would love to vote for our mothers. So I'm urging and I'm encouraging the political parties out there to work out such kind of a framework, kind of platform. When they come into government, they should be able to put up, you know, encourage some of these women that feel, no, me, I cannot make it. I cannot be involved in, politics, or maybe I cannot manage to be a doctor. You know, just give them that kind of encouragement.
The submissions by the NGOCC to the Citizens Manifesto need not fall on deaf ears, as they represent the women's aspirations.
We know that the constitution-making process, we are not done with it as a country, even if we are talking about the referendum now. But I think the issue of incorporating a quota system, as we know that the proportional representation was actually left out when Parliament was amending the current amended constitution as by 2016. So that is imperative that the political parties should be able to begin to walk the talk by ensuring that they incorporate the quota system. But also secondly, that political parties must start now, for example, in preparing for 2021. We expect that the political parties must start preparing now strategically so, but also they must be able to take the agenda for women within their manifesto to begin to formulate, you know, programs that will target the capacitation of many women that would want to stand from, you know, in 2021. Because we believe that, you know, the issue, and even the issue of resourcing for the campaigns, for the different candidates that political parties will adopt, I think it's high time that our political parties prioritized the issue of resource mobilization for its candidate, giving a special focus, I think, on the women candidates that will be in the political parties. Because many of them are challenged, because right now many of them would have actually made it, but of course the resource constraints actually hindered quite a number of them, you know, to be able to be adopted. But there's also the issue which we, as we know, that our current amended constitution has a provision for a minimum of grade 12 certificate. So it's also our expectation that political parties will have a mobilization strategy incorporated within their manifesto, so they can go look out there and be able to mobilize, especially the women and men that have got the minimum qualification, so they can be able to begin to participate in the political parties well in advance. But at the same time also having some kind of strategies that will ensure that their members, especially their committed members who may not have those adequate minimum qualifications, are actually encouraged and given some kind of support for them to secure the required qualifications for them to stand.
It is believed that change is gradual. As the country goes to the polls, it is hoped that the Citizens' Manifesto will be taken seriously and incorporated in the various political party manifestos.